And the truth is always suppressed for business. Coconut oil. 1964, I wrote an article. Coconut oil is as good as mother's milk and the best fat, because coconut oil and mother's milk are the only two things that contain sodium monolauric acid, which is the basis of human immune system. I even wrote there, suspecting doctors who have not studied their biochemistry properly will have a child to go and see the infant food, which is only coconut oil can be used for infant food. If you use any other oil, the infant will die, because only two things that get digested in the mouth, because infant doesn't have the pancreatic juice, pancreatic lipase, so the fat can be digested only by the salivary lipase, and only two things. Even today, you put coconut oil in my mouth, it gets digested there. You don't have to swallow it. It just gets digested and directly goes as ketones. And that is why in America today, coconut oil is a treatment for Alzheimer's disease with very good results. Coconut oil now is the treatment for heart diseases from Harvard. And Harvard has now admitted that because we demonized coconut oil, millions of people have died all over the world. So truth, it's very difficult, very difficult. I tell you, I have suffered so much that in 1984, I gave a talk on coconut oil for the heart in American College of Cardiology meet, where there were 25,000 cardiologists meet in three cities only, because such large conference halls are not there anywhere. And after the talk, they questioned me for a long time. Somehow or other, I survived. Then I was coming out, there was an old cardiologist, he is no more now, may his soul rest in peace. Elliot Corday is his name. He called me and said, young man, do you have any other work in Boston? I said, no, sir. See, it's now 4 o'clock. It will be dark by about 6 o'clock, and the soya lobby is so powerful here, they may bump you off. You better go. This is called truth. This is the truth. You must see the abusive letters I get. I wrote a book called What Doctors Don't Get to Study in Medical School. It came out. There's a big journal in India called the National Medical Journal, which comes from All India Institute. And they think the All India Institute, they're all gods, because they have political clout. You know, he starts with All India Institute as an MBBS student and dies in NCI as this retired director or somebody. Till then, they're all in All India Institute. So he wrote two-page review. The author is a fool. He doesn't know science. He's a bloody fool. And he must be hospitalized. And the book is so bad. The English is horrible. And this and that. And all kinds of rubbish he wrote. Would you believe? Copies were sold in 1 week. So I wrote him a nice letter. Thank you very much for getting all my books sold. Now this book was published in London by a company, English company, on their own. And the British Medical Journal wrote a review which said, this is not a textbook of medicine as claimed by the author, but it's a holy text of medicine written by a prophet. Then all over the world it sold. It is so difficult to tell the truth. So difficult to tell the truth. So be yourself. And go back to your roots. Accept what you are. Because if I am a monkey, if I know I am a monkey and I accept I am a monkey, I have no stress at all. But most of us, if we are monkeys, look at this girl. But most of us, we know we are monkeys, but we want to show to the world we are tigers. Now here is a stress, because every second you have to act like a tiger, act like a tiger. Because if something slips, your monkeyness may be seen by society. So the biggest stress is, you don't know who you are. Try to know who you are. And then, you know, life becomes so easy. Don't keep any secrets inside. Open book. Anybody can write on that book. Open book. And you are so compassionate, so happy. Compassion is thy real meaning. See, we have changed the definition of health now. We, in the sense, we have a group of scientists. We call ourselves the World Academy of Authentic Healing Sciences. We are 15 years old. And I, except me, I'm a villager. The 14 of them are who is who in the world of science. 4 of them are Nobel laureates. And they are very influential people. And we have had a decision to say we must change the definition of health as absence of mental, physical, psychological, spiritual, etc., etc., death. And this is the definition of alma alta is a business thing. Because I tell you what, absence of disease. Now for that we have created a business called checkup. Checkup. You are fine, no? You are fine, but you go to a checkup, you come out as a patient. I'll tell you why. It is very simple. Don't laugh. I'm serious about it. Very serious. Because today, you have a TBS, total body scanner, which scans 500 parameters of your body. Okay. Now a little statistics, even a child knows that what are we doing in medicine for the human body We say your normal blood pressure. What is normal? What is your normal blood pressure is not what my normal blood pressure. Mahatma Gandhi's blood pressure is 210 by 120 all the time. And Sushila Nair was not getting sleep. Mahatma Gandhi was getting good sleep. What is happening here is, I have a friend of mine who started Nimhans as the first founder director, R.V. Verma. R.N. Verma is now 89, you know, 91. This man has been seeing me for the last 45 years saying that his blood pressure is 90 by 40. I told him, why are you worried? Brian Bock's blood pressure is 60 by 40. And he is the strongest man in the world. So what is the problem? He said, see, when the doctors always tell you something to boost the blood pressure, I said, onnu akanda, angane vittidi, ningal irikkum. Ippo 92 years, he says, ah, this man kept me alive for 45 years. I said, I didn't keep alive, that man. So you will never die, you can't die. So your blood pressure is what is your blood pressure. So what is the textbook's blood pressure? It's called the average, statistical average. You check, our friend knows, all chartered accountants understand, actuaries understand that. You take 1,000 people, check their blood pressure, and no blood pressure can be checked correctly by a human being because the very physics of blood pressure is wrong. I won't go into that because it will confuse you. Come back to this. Now what has happened is, you check 1,000, plot it on a XY graph. Okay, na? If correct me if I'm mistaken. Then you have a Gaussian curve called the bell-shaped curve, right? Yes. Then you say mean plus 2 standard deviation. Now that comes to whatever. Now I'll give you an example. What is the normal height of an Indian male? Gaussian curve. 5.4. 2 plus this side, that side. 5.2 plus 5.6. You're normal. Okay? Right? Amitabh Bachchan comes for a checkup. 6.2. Our treatment is cut his legs to make him 5.6. Are what do we do? Sugar ko kya karte hain, blood pressure ko kya karte hain, wahi karte hain. Then next day Jaya Bachchan comes for a checkup. She is 4.6, transplant that leg to her. Day in and day out we doctors are doing this, trying to correct the statistical average, which we tell the common man as normal. So average becomes a normal, there will be what are called false positives. For every parameter, the false positive is 5%. Right, sir? Yes. Now calculate, I'm telling you. When you check 500 parameters, what is the false positive? 2,500. So 100 people go for a checkup, 2,500 patients come out. Isn't that a good business? So there was this professor of medicine in America, her name is Leon Eisenberg, and this girl was 52 years old and she was a very brilliant professor and she was worried about what she was teaching. One day she asked the brightest class boy who passed out, came to research. She said, who is a patient? She asked. She was expecting a very esoteric answer. The boy very simply said, a man or a woman who sees a doctor becomes a patient. She had a shock of her life. She said, then when does he become a man or a woman again? The student thought for a while and said, rarely ever, madam, if ever, full stop. This girl resigned her job as professor of medicine at the age of 52 because she said everything is wrong about medicine. And she sat the MCAT test. MCAT is CET, GET, whatever he has, and got a good grade, joined the medical school, that medical school a student again. Went through 4 years and came out and said, everything that we teach is wrong. Did you get it? You haven't got it because it's not publicized. That article is suppressed. This is very interesting. The first article which studied diet and heart started in 1954, ended in 1959, spent $110 million of the taxpayers' money in America, and the study said diet has nothing to do with heart disease. But by 1959, the myth of fat has gone so much that we have started getting fat-lowering drugs, cholestramine. Have you seen that drug? You have to take 8 tablespoons of that in the morning. It is like sand, and most patients used to vomit it. And that was the beginning of the cholesterol to the statin today. 25 rupees a tablet you give, take it, it kills you. 10% of people who start statin, their blood sugar starts going up. 10% of statin use has become diabetic. So 11 million people take statins in India and 1.1 million diabetics are added every year. Then we proclaim on the other hand by the diabetic drug people, he said India is the capital of diabetes of the world. False. The truth is, India is the best country to have diabetes because Americans are following Indian rice diet for diabetes. South Indian rice diet. Idlis in the morning, brown rice in the afternoon, and brown rice in the evening, and a little fruits here and there, 6 times a day, 8:30, 10:30, 12:30, 3:30, 6:30, 9:30. Small feeds. And don't ever see wheat, because wheat contains gluten. Gluten goes directly to the pancreas and maintains your diabetes. If you're a diabetic, wheat maintains your diabetes. Good, you know, because we want diabetes to be maintained. This is called disease mongering. If everybody is not mad, what will this doctor do? He'll have to close his shop. See, this is called taking medicine to the marketplace. What did Hippocrates say? Cure rarely, comma, comfort mostly, semicolon, console always.